Hello and welcome to Askimo TV. We're talking today to specialist ENT surgeon, Dr. Petros Vlastarakos. Hi, Dr. Vlastarakos, how are you?
Good morning, Joanne. I'm fine, thank you. Thank you for your invitation. And I hope this interview will be interesting for your viewers.
Thank you very much. Dr. Vlastarakos, today we're going to talk about septoplasty. So what is septoplasty and why would somebody need the surgery?
Okay. Now, septoplasty is the surgical correction of the middle partition of your nose, of the nose. It's an endonasal operation. The middle partition of the nose, the septum, is a bony and cartilaginous partition that separates the nose into two nasal cavities. Now, this partition in some occasions is significantly deviated and can cause breathing difficulties during physical exercising or even other problems like recurrent problems with the sinuses, etc. So these matters are affecting the quality of the patient's lives and sometimes they need to be corrected.
Talk me through the operation and what one can expect to happen.
Okay. Now, the operation, as I said, is an endonasal operation. That means that we do an incision inside the nose, so there are no scars to be seen. So inside the nose, in the lining of the nose, in the nasal mucosa, and then we elevate the lining of the nose from both sides, and then we approach the bone and cartilage that comprises the nasal septum, and we remove the deviated parts and let the rest in place. Now you can imagine the septum being like a sandwich with two slices of bread and ham and cheese in the middle. The slices are not the deviated parts. It's the ham and cheese in the middle that we need to nibble. So what we do, in effect, is elevate both slices through one cut inside the nose. So both slices of bread, we nibble the deviated part, put the bread back in place, stitch it up, and that's it. At the same time, in most occasions, we are also cauterizing the turbinates, the inferior turbinates, which are structures at the lateral walls of the nose, which play like an air conditioning, have like an air conditioning effect to the nose, and the incoming air, so they moisten the air, they regulate temperature, and also they clean the incoming air. But sometimes, due to allergic rhinitis or simply due to anatomic reasons, they are quite enlarged. So they also narrow the nasal passages.
Does septoplasty change the appearance of the nose?
Only as a complication. Complication is called subtle nose deformity. So in effect, the nose loses its support and then it can fall like that. But that's a complication of the nose. Our main objective in the septoplasty is to be minimally invasive, so to take the part of the deviated bone or cartilage necessary to align, to correct the septum, but leave the rest intact. Imagine that the septum is like a painting hanging in your wall. What you need definitely to keep, so you can keep the support, is to keep the frame. If you keep the frame, there is no problem. Minor bleeds may occur within the first 2 weeks of the operation, so we advise the patients not to avoid strenuous physical exercising. You will feel a bit congested, obviously, like if you had a bad cold, but that's for a weeks. I would say that sometimes you may experience a temporary teeth numbness involving your upper incisors, the reason being that the septum lies in a rail at the floor of the nose called the maxillary crest, which sometimes if it's grossly deviated we correct it, but that is usually resolved within 3 weeks to 3 months to 2 months, and sometimes if the mucosal lining or if the lining of the nose is torn in both sides, you can be left with a hole, a perforation in the septum. Now that's not visible from the outside, but certainly somebody may not want to have to know that there is a perforation in the nose, so that can be corrected as well.
Dr. Vlastarakos, just to end off, can septoplasty cure snoring and sleep apnea?
I would say that snoring is a multifactorial, is of multifactorial origin. Now, if snoring comes from the deviated septum, which precludes the patient in the night to sleep properly, to breathe properly through the nose, so the patient, because the nose is blocked, the patient opens the mouth and makes that snoring sound, yes, it can improve snoring. But if there are other anatomical problems, like for instance, retrognathia, the chin is a bit back, or there is an elongated uvula that flutters a lot, or a collapse in the, I would say, in the area of the hypopharynx, in the neck here, during inspiration, that can be a problem, and septoplasty will not cure things altogether. So we really need to counsel the patients about snoring. And as far as sleep apnea is concerned, I would say that the same similar things apply. We need to study the apnea very carefully preoperatively. Every obstructive sleep apnea is associated with snoring, but not snoring is not always sleep apnea. So common principles apply, I would say, in the respective management.
Thank you, Dr. Vlastarakos. Thank you so much for talking to me today.
You're most welcome. Have a nice day.